Hello friends, in this video I'm not going to show you the correct way of wrapping PTFE tape over threaded fittings. I'm going to show you the best way. In YouTube I've seen a series of videos where the only tip they offer is wrap it clockwise. Now that's correct, there's nothing wrong with that. However, it is not the only tip you should know when wrapping PTFE tape, and it is not the best way. In this video, I will show you the best way to wrap sealing tape on fittings, especially in gas systems where there are much higher risks if a thread hasn't been sealed correctly. I'll start by telling you that you shouldn't use PTFE tape on everything that has a thread. Not all threaded joints need PTFE tape. As I explained in my video, kinds of joints in gas systems. You'll find the link in the card above and in the description. We only use PTFE tape in those joints where a male thread is screwed into a female threaded fitting, and only in those joints that are accessible to inspection. They aren't buried underground or in the walls. Threaded joints like this one that work by compression shouldn't have sealing tape on them, because the sealing tape there will affect the ability of the compression system to work and seal the joint. Now I'll teach you the correct but also the best way of winding PTFE tape around a fitting. An old gas fitter taught me this method many years ago, and I'm sure it is the best technique, especially with gas systems. Of course, as usual, you wrap the tape clockwise, making sure the starting end is well caught by the tape after the first turn. Now, different to what others suggest in their videos, don't start wrapping with the full width of the tape. You have to prepare a narrow strip of tape. You put it at the beginning here. Hold it with your finger. You make the first turn to capture this loose end and hold it firmly so the tape won't move if you pull it. You wrap it nice and tight so it won't turn on its own while we are wrapping the threads. We wrap one or two more turns in this end to make it quite thick. Then we continue down the thread using wider amounts of tape. So we can create a cone shape of PTFE tape around the thread. A greater amount of tape at the start and less tape at the end. We end the procedure with two or three turns with the tape in its full width, covering all the thread. Then we pull it firmly so it integrates with the rest of the sealing tape and it does not unwrap while we screw in the female thread. With white PTFE tape used for water systems, we usually have to make many turns around the thread so it gets thick enough. This PTFE tape is very thin, and that makes it very useful for sealing PVC fittings, which don't tolerate too much pressure and might crack if we use a thick sealant like hemp. With yellow PTFE tape for gas, which is much denser, we might need only a few turns. The important thing is to be able to create a cone-shaped cover of tape around the thread, as you can see here. Thinner at the beginning and thicker at the end. To understand the purpose of this, we must understand what happens to the tape inside the threads when we turn one thread inside the other. In this image, I show how the PTFE tape is squashed between the flanks of a thread. As there is a limit to the compressibility of the PTFE tape, it is pushed all over the surface of the flanks, filling in every available space. Any excess of PTFE tape is pushed into neighboring flanks, roots, and crests, and eventually is pushed out at the end of the fittings thread. By creating a cone-shaped cover of PTFE tape, we ensure that at some point along the thread, there will be enough sealing tape to cover every corner of the interstitial space between the threads. And once that is reached, all threads after that will be perfectly sealed. And any excess is pushed out the other end. Having a thin amount of PTFE tape at the beginning ensures the female thread will squash the tape into the threads instead of pushing it away, as can happen sometimes when we don't wrap it up tight enough. Now, I'm doing this by hand, but eventually we must use a tool to tighten it up, practically up to the end here. Well, friends, I hope you liked this video, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up, share it, and subscribe to my channel. And I'd love to hear your comments about my channel, this video, and anything you'd like to share. So please comment below with anything any question you have. Well, thanks for watching. Goodbye.